Hello everyone, my name is Levanjan. So today I'm going to begin my research on micro-mechanical model for describing the organism fuzzy cracking in the discipline solar alarm. This is a part of my PhD work in the cooperation between the University of Kansai and the company of Valeo. You can see here the outline of my presentation. Now I will begin by introduction, context, and objective. So the IGBT power motor is a microelectronic component. It's increasing uses in the domain of the high energy for many applications. For example, renewable energy, car, railway, electrification. In the function, the IGBT motor is submitted to a thermocycling. It's VN also the a big mass of thermal expansion coefficient is a focal for many follow. For example, switch value, deformation of chip magnetism, degrade of white body, and the most important and difficult for studying is fatigue follow of solenoid. You can see here is an example for solar fatigue crack. So it is also my subject for research. In a IGBT also the solar joints being a thing that very small, maybe some few grams, you can see here, very small. And the fatigue lemma is almost follow along grand boundaries. So the fatigue behaviors as the grand scale has to be account for in the fatigue analysis of the solder. Currently, for studying the fatigue of solder zone, we use normally the empirical relation law like Dabo, Boho, Miner is based on microscopic behaviors like stress. Less stress, plastic strain is fatigue energy. So, this empirical law is the free and advantage for energy application, but so also inconvenient for describing the fatigue behaviors in this scale. So here we focus. Numerical methodology for reproducing the intergranular fatigue crack in the solar zone of an IGBT motor. So now I will talk about the numerical methodology. So for results, firstly I will simulate global model of IGBT for detecting the critical zone and also the boundary constant. Because the mechanical behavior needs expensive energy calculation and also needs a long time, so this is that we apply the simulant for study this local model. And in this local model, we apply the crypto plasticity for describing the behaviors of a grain and also the cohesive zone for describing the intergranular fatigue. So you can see here the functionality of a numerical methodology. Here is the global model of IGBT, is the local model, submodern, and also the intergranular crack propagation. So now I continue by finished element modeling. You can see here the geometric model of the assembly is consist of many material layer. Example, tie, subtie, base plate, and also the material solder. This is the finished element model. Here we apply the Pasibat the most sibling with the period of 5,600 second and zero temperature from 10 to 18 degrees. Concerning the material property for the solar PIBUS, we use the viscoelasticity model of Anand. And the parameter, we identify the parameter based on the experimental data. You can see here the comparison between the predicted PIBUS and experimental data for the sky for different strategy. It's so agrees between for different standard. For OEM material is the temperature dependent elastic behavior. So I saw here some free measuring result. You can see here the critical zone located at the corner of the boundary solar layer and a quick cyclic stabilization of the solar behavior. For the local model, about geometry, the sub-model is the limits to a reduction of around the critical point in the solder, and the critical solder in the solder is modelized by a grain microstructure. For the boundary condition, the boundary condition is the sub-model and is described by the corresponding nodal displacement is a global model. So for the crystal processing model, here we use the thermometry of pistol and rod. And for the microstructure of the solar cell, is 322 sleep system in weak 22 active system. We use a subtin UMAS for define the microstructure behavior. So for identification of parameter for crystal processing model, we use the transition zone of Beckwith-Zawi. So I plot here the compare of the experimental data and implementation of the calibration process in MATLAB. You can see here the parameter identified. For the cohesive zone across the for grain boundary, so in fact the cohesive zone is used for describing the damage of cohesive structure. But here we use the cohesive zone for describing the integrella crack, fatigue crack. So we use a scan variable for describing the irreversible fatigue damage. And here I showed you some parameters. And I've closed the relation between the torsion and simulation. So, I've yet here some results about cyclic thruster separation relation, and also you see here damage distribution at grain boundary. I plot here the relation between the plastic slip for following rain and also the plastic slip distribution here, so for cycle 5. I saw here the intergranular crack propagation follows some cycle. So based on numerical result, I can conclude some remark. Most of the early damage initially as the intersection of grain boundary with the external surface of the model, and dominant damage nucleation occurs in the same critical zone. And that is the global model, and also intergranular cracking propagate from outside and inside by following almost orientation. So about evolution of fatal cracker, we found just the number of degrees cohesive element and cyclic number is 15 by a second order polynomial relation, and the Dampier propagation is almost stable. So we have a type simple extrapolation for this for lifetime of the global mode. So based on the quantity of the local model. So I conclude by some concluding and remarks. In this system, a numerical methodology is proposed to product intergranular fatigue graph. And the numerical results of a good agreement with experimental observation of the failure mechanism. And suggesting the global fatigue lifetime can be predicted by sample extrapolation of, from the local model. So here I give some work for the future. So thank you for the attention.